Hi everyone, and welcome to DC Public Library STEM Time. I'm Miss Tara. So today we're doing a science project for STEM, and the science project just requires one orange. Now I have two, and that's because I need to keep things running and on time for this video. But you only need one, and then you need a container of water big enough to fit whatever size orange you have. Okay, so if I put this orange into the water, do you think it's going to sink or float? Yes, I know, another sink or float experiment. But this is actually really, really cool, and you're going to be surprised by the results. So is it going to sink or is it going to float? Do you have your prediction? All right, here we go. Did you expect it to float? It does. All right. Now, what if I peel the orange? That's why I have the second orange. But at home, you can peel the orange that you just dipped in. Is the peeled orange going to sink or is it going to float? Do you have your prediction? What's your hypothesis? Okay, here we go. It sinks. Now, why is this? Well, the answer lies in an orange, the skin of the orange itself. Do you see the bumps on the orange? Those little dimples that it has? An orange's skin is very porous. And what that means is that basically there's little pockets of air that are able to keep the orange with its skin on afloat. Now, when we peel this skin, it sinks, you know, and it's a little surprising. Another fruit that this happens with is lemons. And you can see there's that porous part of the lemon. Let's be sure I'm right. Is it going to sink or is it going to float? So it floats. Now, if I peel this, you would have to see if it's going to sink or float. If it's like the orange and it goes to the bottom, or if it tricks us and stays at the top. But I'll give you a hint. It's very much like the orange in the fact that it has this dimpled, porous, air pocket friendly skin that keeps it afloat or makes it sink when we take it away. Now, there's another fruit that you can try this experiment with, and that's limes. And if you happen to have limes in your house, I do not, but if you happen to have limes, you're really going to be surprised by the results. And you're going to find that they, I don't want to spoil it. Okay, I won't spoil it. But I'll tell you that you can test it out with the limes and then go to dclibrary.org to figure out how density works. So use some of the resources there to look up terms, scientific terms like mass and density to figure out this whole sink or float thing in detail. Okay, until next time, thank you for joining me at the DC Public Library for STEM Time, and I hope to see you again soon, and don't forget to check out dclibrary.org. Take care.
DC Public Library, we are here with you.